We've got just over a week left to finish up this old body style Ford that we're doing for All-Star pitcher Jacob DeGrom. Up front, the mounting bracket we designed to attach the lift to the frame is working like a charm.
Yeah, dang. Feels good. Yeah, it feels real good.
We've removed the bed and the cap to clean it up and prep for paint. We also upgraded the existing leaf spring suspension and replaced those old worn-out shocks with brand new ones from Bilstein.
It's like, look, this one's still trying to move up.
Now, it's time to get this bad boy some new shoes.
Yep, we're taking some 37-inch tires, mounting them on 22-inch American Force dually wheels to give this truck that aggressive stance, but also keep it very functional.
Tire delivery.
Some nice, sloppy tire lube for you. If you don't use the lube, there's no way you're gonna be able to slide this smaller diameter past this larger diameter.
There you go. I'm gonna mount this on the machine first.
When mounting tires, the first bead to slip over the wheel is usually the easiest. That's why I figured we could just do it on the ground. But these are kind of big wheels, big tires, new rubber. I'm gonna put it on the tire machine and then drop it on there so we can get more leverage and more weight on it without damaging the wheel.
Lube it up.
Need a scrubber like this in my shower.
Nice, good, good. Give it to it, need it, love it, want it.
Now that we got the first bead of the tire around the first part of the rim, we gotta use the tire machine to get the second part of the tire bead onto the rim. This is the more tricky part because obviously the tire bead is a smaller diameter than the outer diameter of the wheel. It has to be that way because that's what actually holds the air inside the wheel.
There it is. It's gonna make it.
Now is the tricky part because you actually have to seat the beads. I mean, you have to put enough air in this tire to push both sides out to lock it in place.
Put your finger in there.
Nope. Put a hot dog in there for demonstration. There it is.
This right here is what you call a seated bead. And when you hear it pop like that, that means the outer edge of the tire slipped into the little groove on the outer edge of the wheel.
Now, the truck has got a fresh coat of black paint, and it's time to reassemble it, put the fenders on, put everything back in place so that we can finish off the beautiful two-tone paint job that we have in mind. All right, Damon, so bed is ready.
Ready to go.
So do you want to get on the truck first, and then we'll do the bed sides?
Yeah, we'll sit them on there. That way we can put these on, and then we can get them up there, and then we can make sure everything fits good, and I can make my lines for the two-tone, and then we can pull them back off.
Well, let's get the bed on and see how it looks.
Spin it like this, and then push it right next to the truck. All right, set it down.
This right here is a quick, effective way to completely transform your truck. You know, you can have a single rear wheel truck, throw these fenders on it, and all of a sudden you got a full-blown dually that looks like it's from the factory, but these are a little bit bigger and bulgier body lines. Once we get some color in this middle section here, it's gonna wake this whole thing up. It's gonna make it feel like it's got big wide hips. It's gonna match the big wide tires, and that's why we're converting it to a dually. That's a good looking body line, dude.
It is, they line up
great. I mean, being
great.
All black, it's getting lost, but once we get some color on that, hey, let's get the other side on and be good to go. We only had 2 weeks to completely transform a 1996 Ford truck for MLB pitcher Jacob DeGrom. The time we had and the resources we were given, I feel like the truck turned out amazing.
So here we are in Queens, New York, so that we can meet Jacob DeGrom and give him his OBS truck back. Hey, what's up, Jacob?
How you doing?
Good, buddy.
Come to New York and just get a baseball field?
Oh, yeah, man. Bayside, yeah. Little League never disappoints.
I wish I had pull like that.
How long you been a truck guy?
That was my first vehicle, was a truck.
There's nothing prettier than the old body styles of Fords, and I think it's probably the prettiest OBS I've ever seen.
All right, I can't wait to see it. Hope it doesn't disappoint.
You think you're ready?
I'm ready.
Hey, Benny the Jet Rodriguez.
Are we really doing Sandlot jokes?
Play ball!
I've never met Jacob. I don't know what his taste and style is.
You hear it?
I hear it.
We went crazy. This truck is way different now than when it showed up at our shop. So there's a potential that Jacob shows up and he hates orange. We're just gonna deal with it.
And then he beans you. There it is!
It doesn't turn out how I liked. I think he's getting a fastball. It's unbelievable.
Yeah!
Yes! That is sick.
Yeah? Well, you like it?
I love it. I love it. Wow. That is impressive. It didn't leave a dually.
It did not leave a dually, no.
Very impressed with the color, everything.
Yeah. You guys nailed it. You like the color?
Love it.
This is called hot lava. So you got like this dark, dark black, and then you got like this really intense metal flake. The dually conversion, we were able to keep your factory axles. That gave us the ability to put more into like the wheels and the tires and everything else that you wanted to do. This is an aftermarket fiberglass fender. It bolted to your original bed sides, which is awesome because if you ever have to do body work or any sort of repairs, all this stuff is just removed really easily. We took the front end and we wanted to maintain that menacing look. Like, dude, look at it. Fusion bumpers, and it flows perfectly into the cab visor.
Love it. My grandpa had a truck that had the visor. When I saw it, you know, made me think of that truck.
It's almost like the mullet, right? Like, dude, it's like the 80s, 90s, like the bad boy haircut. You had some long hair.
I had some long
hair. Where'd your hair go?
I got rid of it.
We were able to do a brand new lift kit all the way around. You got new leaf springs front and rear. You got new Bilstein shocks. Those are gonna give you a much smoother ride as you go down the road. Happy with it?
Oh, I can't even express how much I love it. You guys did a great job.